Hi, this is Gerardo Valero. I haven't recently seen the Wolfman movie. Today I'd like to talk to you about an American werewolf in London. It is, to me, a rarity because it is as much a horror film as it is a comedy, and I believe it works just as well on both counts. It has special effects that were groundbreaking for its time, but also downright scary. For the first time in history, we finally got to see a Wolfman transformation that not only consisted of a guy growing hair rapidly. That something like this could be so painful was something that really never crossed my mind until I watched these two movies. You may think this was a big budget movie, but it really wasn't. Then why was it so much scarier than the recent Wolfman movie? Perhaps because it used the Jaws technique of only showing us the monster little by little, initially only hinting at his appearance. Also because the first attacks or the first victims, we only really got to see the point of view of the camera and people being chased, instead of getting all these gory images that come on later on in the movie. Just think of the fantastic chase scene at the Tottenham Court Road station in London, in which something that lasts about 2 minutes, we only get to see about 2 seconds from the beast itself. That the victim's desperation becomes the audience, I believe it is so because we get to see somebody so full of adrenaline that is paralyzed and this becomes his doom. And I believe this is the stuff that nightmares are really made of. And this is also a very original movie. For the first time we get to see a new twist on the "is this only a dream" sequence. I don't think I've ever seen one double one, and that's what made it so original. And really, Roger, to me, this isn't something that you can say, "I hate it when this happens." Now, the movie really works also as a comedy. We laugh when we see the main character talking to his dead friend and with the victims. We also laugh when he wakes up naked in the middle of the London Zoo surrounded by wolves. We laugh when he steals his balloons from a little boy so that he can cover himself. And it is also very funny when this little boy says something of the like of, "An American man just stole my balloons." Now, I really hate to sound like I love old movies more than new ones, because I really don't. But really, if you want to see a good Wolfman movie, rent the old one, forget the new. And now I want to propose another suggestion for Ebert's little movie glossary, and it's called "In the Future You Don't Need Ultrasound Machines." Whenever we see a futuristic movie in which technology is so much more advanced than today's, and we get to see a baby being born, invariably the sex of the baby will only be known at the moment of birth, which really makes no sense because you would think that with the technology they could make an ultrasound machine really that could fit into your pocket. Think for example of the birth of Luke and Leia on the Revenge of the Sith, or on the recent Star Trek movie when James T. Kirk is born. Anyway, thanks for listening, and until next time, el balcón está cerrado.